In the middle of a dark, quiet room, filled only by the sounds of humming machines, a figure floats, suspended. She, ICEY, has no memories, no past. Memories to her are not important. Her existence only serves one purpose: to kill Judas. That wicked devil, the bringer of the apocalypse. No matter how many difficulties or obstacles she will face, ICEY understands that she must accomplish her mission. Destroy Judas. In the darkness, ICEY awakes. ICEY has left the laboratory. She understands that as long as she follows the arrow, she will discover where Judas is hiding. ICEY has left the laboratory. She understands that as long as she follows the arrow, she will discover where Judas is hiding. Oh, more soldiers sent by Judas to stop ICEY. Kill them! ICEY reaches a quiet hill, illuminated by light dancing off of the lake below. She is at peace. There seems to be a console that will activate the photon bridge. ICEY moves to activate it. ICEY slips off the edge of the cliff. ICEY is absolutely positive that the only way to cross the ravine is by activating the photon bridge.
What? How did...
A disgusting swamp rests, unmoving, in front of ICEY. She must carefully jump across. ICEY arrives in the Moonlight Forest. In front of her waits Daha. Wait, where's the bridge? Right, just keep following the arrow. Whoa, what? How did you come in here? This... something's wrong here. ICEY arrives at an unnamed town. There is not a soul in sight. ICEY searches around the house for a trace of someone, a mark of some presence. It seems as if everyone has been wiped out. The culprit? Most likely Judas. ICEY decides to head deeper into town, not hesitating to follow the arrow. ICEY ignores yet another arrow and selfishly continues on her own path. What ICEY doesn't realize is that unless she defeats Thor in the village, Ultimopolis gates will refuse her entry.